like. I've been there and I've seen it. I know just what it's like. I've been through it all. I've seen the sizzling fires of hell and the steaming rocks of perdition. I know what it's like. Tell you about the time I took a contract to bury the body. To bury the body of Blasphemous Bill Mackay. Whenever, wherever, or whatsoever the manner of death he die, whether he die in the light of day or under the peak-faced moon, in cabin, or dance hall, or dive, mucklucks, or patent shoon, on velvet tundra or virgin peak, by glacier, drift, or draw, in muskeg hollow, or canyon gloom, by avalanche, fang, or claw, by battle, murder, or sudden wealth, by pestilence, hooch, or lead. I swore on the book I would follow and look till I found my tombless dead. For Bill was a dainty kind of cuss, and his mind was mighty sot on a dinky patch with flowers and grass and a civilized boneyard lot. And where he died or how he died, it didn't matter a damn, so long as he had a grave with frills and a tombstone epigram. So I promised him, and he paid the price in good Chicheco coin, which the same, I admit, I blowed in that very night down in the Tenderloin. Then I painted a 3-foot slab of pine. Here lies poor Bill Mackay. And I hung it up in my cabin wall, and I waited for Bill to die. Years passed away, and at last one day came a squaw with a story strange of a long deserted line of traps way back at the Bighorn Range, of a little hut by the Great Divide, and a white man, stiff and still, lying there by his lonesome self, and I figured it must be Bill. So I thought of the contract I've made with him, and I took down from the shelf the swell black box with the silver plate he'd picked out for himself. And I packed it full of grub and hooch, and I slung it on the sleigh. Then I harnessed up my team of dogs, and I was off at the dawn of day. You know what it's like in the Yukon wild when it's 69 below, when the ice worms wriggle their purple heads through the crust of the pale blue snow, when the pine trees crackle like little guns in the silence of the wood, and the icicles hang down like tusks from the parka hood, when the stovepipe smoke breaks sudden off, and the sky is weirdly lit, and the careless feel of a bit of steel burns like a red-hot spit, when the mercury is a frozen ball and the frost fiend stalks to kill. Well, it was just like that, that day that I set out to look for Bill. Oh, the awful hush that seemed to crush me down on every hand as I blundered blind with a trail to find through that blank and bitter land. Half dazed, half crazed in the winter wild with its grim, heartbreaking woes and the ruthless strife of a grip on life that only the sourdough knows. North by the compass, north I pressed. River and peak and plain passed like a dream. I slept to lose, and I waked to dream again. River and plain and mighty peak, and who could stand unawed? As their summits blazed, he could stand undazed at the foot of the throne of God. North, aye, north, through a land accursed, shunned even by the scouring brutes, until all I heard was my own harsh word and the whine of my malamutes. till at last I came to a cabin, squat, built on the side of a hill, and I burst in the door. And there on the floor, frozen to death, lay Bill. Ice, white ice, like a winding sheet, sheathing each smoke-grimed wall, ice on the stovepipe, ice on the bed, ice gleaming over all. Sparkling ice on the dead man's chest, sparkling ice in his hair, ice on his fingers, ice in his heart, ice in his glassy stare, hard as a log, and trussed like a frog with his arms and legs outspread. I gazed at the coffin I'd brought for him, and I gazed at the gruesome dead. And at last I spoke. Bill liked his joke, but still, gol darn his eyes, a man had ought to consider his mates in the way he goes and dies. Have you ever stood in the Arctic hut, in the shadow of the pole with a little coffin, 6x3, and a grief you can't control? Have you ever sat by a frozen corpse that looks at you with a grin and that seems to say, you may try all day, but you'll never jam me in? Well, I'm not a man of the quitting kind, but I never felt so blue as I sat there gazing at that stiff and studying what I do. Then I rose, and I kicked off the husky dogs that were nosing round about, and I lit a roaring fire in the stove, and I started to thaw Bill out. Well, I thawed, and I thawed for 13 days, but it didn't seem no good. His arms and his legs stuck out like pegs of wood, as if they were made of wood. Till at last I said, it ain't no use. He's froze too hard to thaw. He's obstinate, and he won't lie straight. So, I guess I got to saw. So I sawed off poor Bill's arms and legs, and I laid him snug and straight in the little coffin he picked himself with the dinky silver plate. And I came nigh to shedding a tear as I nailed him safely down. Then I stowed him away in my Yukon sleigh, and I started back to town. So I buried him, as the contract was, in a narrow grave and deep. And there he's waiting the great cleanup, when the judgment's sluice heads sweep, and I smoke my pipe and I meditate in the light of the midnight sun, you know? And sometimes I wonder if they ever was, the awful things are done. And as I sit and the parson talks, expounding of the law, I often think of poor old Bill and how hard he was to saw. Ba-ba-ba-ba. Oh, 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 I've been there and I've seen it. I've been a-wading through it up to my britches. Knee-deep I've been there. Ba-ba-ba, I've been up that creek. I lost my paddle just like the rest of you. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba